So a lot of the IFACs that I've seen that mount to your belt belt have like a sleeve design that you pull out and you're able to pull in front of you. What's cool about ours is that it mounts to the belt, but as soon as you unclip it, you can actually tear away the whole pouch from this Velcro backing and have it in front of you. This way you're not fumbling around trying to reach behind you to grab anything, and you can lay it all out in front of you and have everything. Another thing that I noticed with a lot of the IFACs on the market was that once you have it all out in front of you, a lot of it was shrink wrapped in one container, and as soon as you open it, that stuff just kind of spills out everywhere. So when it's time to go, you either got to leave it or you're stuck trying to gather everything. The cool thing about ours is that everything is stable in here alone. You can pull out exactly what you need, and if you need to go again quickly, you can just slap it back on there, open, close, doesn't matter, and just get out, and you're not leaving a bunch of your medical stuff there. So let's talk about what's inside and what I did a little differently. So you've got your tourniquet down here. It's a cat tourniquet, and a lot of the IFACs only come with one tourniquet. Now, in our department, in our protocols, state that if you have a tourniquet and you can't control the wound with direct pressure, then you put a tourniquet on it, and if that doesn't control the bleeding, you place a secondary tourniquet. Most IFACs only come with one tourniquet. So what we did was added a secondary tourniquet, which most of IFACs don't have in it. This is the SWAT-T tourniquet. A big thing people always say is like, where's your Israeli bandage, right? Israeli bandages are really bulky and take up a lot of space and really only perform, you know, a couple functions. With the SWAT-T tourniquet and the combat gauze, you can create an Israeli bandage. You put your combat gauze on the wound and then wrap it with a SWAT-T, not tourniquet type, but you just wrap it and you have an Israeli bandage right there. So instead of having a bulky Israeli bandage in there and only one tourniquet, we decided to do two tourniquets for your backup tourniquet or an Israeli bandage if you really need it, which is really nice. So you do get the combat gauze. We've got NAR wound packing gauze. And this is pretty cool. There's a decent amount in here. You could probably pack more than one wound with just this one little piece. And we include two of those in every kit. And we got shrink wrapped wound packing gauze. Everything in here is individually wrapped and shrink wrapped to be water resistant. But that comes in it. You've got the Celox granules for pouring in, actually. And all this stuff has directions on the back, which is really cool. This stuff is super useful. You have trauma shears that come in every IFAC. A lot of IFACs don't come with trauma shears, so that's pretty cool. Next, you have two chest seals. Entry and exit wound, and we will have YouTube videos on how to use each one of these pieces of equipment and the proper use to do it. And inside each IFAC, you'll have a QR code if you need it. If you forget how to do something or whatever, you just scan it, it'll pop up, and it'll go right to our YouTube channel where you can learn how to do all of this stuff. And we're also collaborating with a couple other companies, one company called Frontline Medical, who's also doing a lot of training. And these will be available at Georgia Firing Line as well. We'll be doing a lot of training and media with them. If you want to take in-person classes, we'll be doing medical training at Georgia Firing Line. And you can buy our kits there or you can buy them online. Next, it comes with gloves. One pair of rubber gloves. And then you can kind of add whatever else you really want. I added a needle decompression kit. This does not come with our kits, unfortunately. You used to be able to buy these and just add these. This is not covered under the Good Samaritan laws, meaning if you try to help somebody with this and you end up doing something wrong because it's like an invasive procedure, technically you have to be under medical direction now. This is also a 14 gauge and they've changed it to a 10 gauge. So the laws on these have changed. If you have some already in your kits, good for you. If you're able to get some, I would suggest learning how to use these. We'll do videos on how to use them. But again, this don't go start punching holes in people's chests on the street because you may end up in jail. Another thing I keep is this old expired saline flush. I would not suggest actually getting an IV or injecting it into an IV site. I threw it in there because I have it, and I thought maybe if I had something in my eye or something and I needed to flush or even flush a wound externally or something, just get some saline on it, I could use it. Not necessary. If you anything else that you know you might need that you might want to add personally to your kit, that's what I did. That's why I have these. But all of the stuff that I explained does come in our IFAC. And it's really cool. It's really about double what comes in most IFACs. And that's why I'm really excited to release it and really get it to you guys and get this training going. So these are available on the site. I just released them and we're already almost sold out. We only have a few of these kits left. So if you want one, I definitely recommend going and grabbing them. We will restock pretty soon. But yeah, so stay tuned for more medical stuff. We're going to be going through what's in these guys, the big boys, pretty soon. And we'll see you next time.